Hi there! Today I want to talk with you about test-driven development. What are the benefits or drawbacks of the test-driven development? By the way, do you think it was scientifically proven that test-driven development is beneficial? If you want to know that, watch video until the end. Closer to the end of the video, I will give you an answer to this question. As you probably know, I work in a company called which is one of those companies which really follow extreme programming practices. At the daily basis, what we do, we pair with each other, we implement our software using test-driven development. So I have some practical experience with test-driven development, and I wanted to share my opinion regarding TDD. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel, it really helps me a lot. Before anything, what is test-driven development in the first place? Test-driven development is a style of development in which we use tests to drive or guide our implementation. If you want to see how it works in real life, soon I will publish a FizzBuzz video where I will actually show you step by step how you use test-driven development. But for now, let's concentrate on the three rules of the test-driven development. I don't remember this off the top of my head, so I will just read this for you. First rule, write production code only to pass a failing unit test. Second rule, write no more of a unit test than sufficient to fail. Compilation failures are failures. And then write no more production code than necessary to pass the failing unit test. Now, the important thing here is that rules were formulated back in the days where the unit test was meaning something different from what it is now. And by unit test, people would mean basically any automated tests that were written by developers. There are more than one schools of thoughts of the test-driven development. But the important thing is that we always use our tests to guide the implementation. And TDD encourages a very short feedback loops, sometimes in a matter of minutes, and really small implementation steps. Let me start with the most obvious benefits of the test-driven development and go to the least obvious benefits. First of all, by using test-driven development, you almost guaranteed to get high and meaningful code coverage. In a typical test-driven development loop, you don't write production code unless there is a failing test for this code already. So, quality of production code and the tests themselves is usually better. You don't need things like mutation testing or anything like that to verify that your tests are actually checking something because you saw those tests failing without the implementation. You know that they should be good. And that leads to the other benefits of the test-driven development, which is the confidence in your code. You know you can release sooner because your code was unit tested, which of course would lead to the bug density decrease. You make fewer bugs. Unit tests that you have created can be a very good documentation for new developers that join your project. For example, new developer, instead of trying to understand the product code, can actually go through the tests that you had written and have a very good understanding of what the product code is trying to achieve. Some people would say that test-driven development is very difficult because the technologies that you use, the framework they use or anything is not very well suited for unit tests and requires more integration level tests, which is another benefit of the test-driven development. You see, unit tests that you write, they give you a very important and critical feedback about your application. There is a very good correlation between how modular and granular your application is with how easy to unit test that. So essentially, if it is difficult to unit test your application, it may mean that the application itself is a problem rather than unit tests being bad. Now, to the most surprising and least known benefits of the test-driven development. By using test-driven development, by actually following these short red-green refactor loops, you might get lots of positive reinforcement, which makes programming a very enjoyable activity. It is actually really satisfying to see how you go from nothing at all to something that works, and not only works, but also was tested. Just think about the prospect of writing a production code for several hours, getting really tired and frustrated, only to find out that now you need to write unit tests for this code. It can be really annoying. With test-driven development, you guaranteed not to have this kind of problem, because you don't write any code unless there is already test for this. So what are the drawbacks of test-driven development? I myself am a test-driven development practitioner, so it was not so easy for me to find any, but I tried really hard. And I think I was able to come up with something really interesting. Something that will surprise lots of TDD practitioners. And again, let's start with obvious. Test-driven development requires training. In order to be able to successfully use test-driven development, in order to be able to test-drive the implementation, one has to learn how to do this. And that would require some time and discipline to do this, because the process itself is counterintuitive. There is also a little bit of the confusion between different schools of the test-driven development. And what happens sometimes, people argue about the merits of test-driven development, and they are arguing about different schools of test-driven development, so the conversation that they have is not very meaningful. Now to the more interesting drawbacks of test-driven development. While test-driven development will certainly help you to come up with the working algorithm for a particular problem, it most likely will not help you to develop an efficient or fastest or less resource-greedy algorithm. For this, you will actually have to learn algorithms and do some kind of either design upfront or implementation upfront. Otherwise, you may actually try to test drive the algorithm, but you will come up with the what is known brute force solution, which you will need to essentially re-implement from scratch. And related to this previous point is that sometimes if you use test-driven development, you can actually spend more time and come up with a worse solution than if you would be doing test-loss development. And that comes back to these tricky tasks where the best algorithm will not be the most intuitive one. For example, let's have a look at this simple Mars rover kata implementation in Python.
Simple Mars rover kata is a TDD kata where you need to model Mars rover moving on the grid, controlled by simple textual commands. A typical solution to this kata would be to calculate x and y coordinates separately. That would involve several decision points and rotating commands would be specifically tricky. However, it is possible to simplify the kata using complex numbers instead of x and y coordinates.
It's the shortest one that I've seen. But the important thing here is that it has just only three if statements. It is actually simpler and more reliable than any algorithm that you could test drive for this kata. By the way, if you want me to solve this kata on a video using test-driven development and explain this simpler, more reliable, yet not test-driven solution, please drop comment. And if I have, I don't know, 5 comments asking for me to make this video, I will make this video for you. So taking all what I have said into account, it is quite obvious that test-driven development might be an overkill in some scenarios, for example, for proof of concept or for throwaway code where you don't actually need any kind of maintainability. Now back to the question that I asked at the start of the video. Is it scientifically proven that test-driven development is actually beneficial for your development? And the answer is actually very interesting. So far, the scientific evidence that we have is conflicting. There are lots of papers confirming that test-driven development is beneficial, and there's also quite a lot of papers disproving this idea. I would say there is a draw, and we don't have any reliable scientific consensus on the question if test-driven development is actually helpful and effective. What do you think about test-driven development? Do you agree with the drawbacks and benefits that I just mentioned? Please feel free to drop the comment, like, subscribe and share this video, and see you in a week.